Hi. In this video, we're using Substance 3D Designer to explore the possibilities of the new Bevel Smooth node. Let's go over the keynotes and parameters we'll use first. The Bevel Smooth node draws a gradient or a flat color from the borders of a mask outward, inward, or both. With output mode, you have control over the dilation. Bevel draws a gradient, dilation, a solid color, and distance is used for the raw distance from the closest mask border. Direction defines the mask border, which should be dilated. In draws towards the interior, out is used for exterior dilation, and in and out for a combination of both. Maximum distance adjusts the range of dilation. Mask offset moves the mask borders in or outward. Compared to regular bevel, the Bevel Smooth node gives a much higher quality result. When smoothing is used, the sharp edges stay sharp compared to the smoother edges of the bevel node. Let's dive into some examples about the various functions of the Bevel Smooth node. With the Bevel Smooth node, you have the possibilities to make directional bevels in X and Y direction. This is great to make nice directional bevel shapes. With mask smoothness, you smooth out your mask. This really helps to keep a sharp bevel, while you can smooth out the mask outline. With mask offset, you can further move the mask borders in or outwards. Use a tiled shape node with disc shapes as base. Connect it to a bevel smooth node in dilation mode with in and out direction. Using a crystal 1 node as a distance map creates thickness variation, resulting in nice gloss stain effects. Tweak the distance map scale and play with the maximum distance value of the bevel smooth node to tweak the details amount and shape thickness. With the output mode set to bevel, you get great edge details controlled by a specific distance map. Either subtract details from a shape, add details to a shape, or get just the edge details. By using different noise inputs, you can get really sharp results, but as well soft details. The smaller the noise is, the more you have to reduce the maximum distance for nice results. This is great to add all kinds of edge details to, for example, tiles and planks. Use the dilation mode in combination with a source input to dilate inwards, outwards, or in both directions. This is the UV output, which is generated by the Bevel Smooth node. It can be connected to a UV mapper node to map any other image using these dilated UVs. Blur those results and blend them, for example, on top of your bevel shape for additional details. You can also connect it to vector inputs of the vector warp and vector morph nodes to deform inputs. Or use it as the vector map input of the tile sampler node to randomize various parameters based on it. Use the Bevel Smooth node in combination with any cells node to get some nice crack variation. You have to use a distance map input to define the shapes you want to subtract of your cracks. Control the subtraction with the maximum distance parameter. You can get really interesting results by experimenting with various inputs and cells pattern. With these methods, you can create so many different things. Have fun while experimenting with it. If you want to learn more, you can download and open the graph shown in the video. Thanks for watching, and we would love to hear your thoughts, ideas, and suggestions for future quick tips. So let us know them in the comments. See you in the next quick tip episode.